Classical Western Philosophy, Plato. Introduction. Plato was an ancient Greek philosopher who was the pupil of Socrates and the teacher of Aristotle. He is considered as a towering figure in the history of Greek and Western philosophy. He founded the Platonist school of thought and the academy at Athens, which is known to be the first institution of higher learning in Western world. Aristotle studied at his academy for about 22 years before he founded his own school, Lyceum. Literature. Plato is regarded to be the innovator of the dialectic form of philosophy. He wrote a number of literary works. A total number of 35 dialogues have been ascribed to Plato. His literary works are called dialogues. Some of his famous dialogues are Meno, Crito, Republic, Phaedo, Phaedrus, Symposium, Sophists, Theaetetus, Timaeus, etc. His dialogues are classified into three stages. The three stages are number 1, early dialogues, apology, Gorgias, Crito, Protagoras, etc. They deal with his positive epistemological teachings. They also give an elaborate account of the historical teachings of Socrates, who was his master. Number 2, middle dialogues, Parmenides, Phaedo, Phaedrus, Republic, Symposium, Theaetetus, etc. They also deal with his positive epistemological teachings, for example, the theory of forms, the nature of knowledge, the theory of justice, etc. Number 3, late dialogues, Sophists, Timaeus, Laws, etc. They are regarded to be difficult or challenging pieces of the work of philosophy. The theory of knowledge. Plato's epistemology cannot be derived from his one single work because his epistemology deals with subgroups. The two subgroups are positive epistemology and negative epistemology. Under positive epistemology, Plato deals with the theories and ideas regarding the nature of knowledge, the nature of truth and reality, nature of justice, nature of good, the validity of knowledge and truth, etc. One of his dialogues which deals with positive epistemology is the Republic. On the other hand, under negative epistemology, Plato deals with theories and ideas regarding the nature of false knowledge, the nature of untruth, the nature of error, etc. One of his dialogues which deal with negative epistemology is Theaetetus. Hence, in order to understand the theory of knowledge or epistemology of Plato, it is very important to understand and take into consideration all his dialogues which deal with both positive and negative epistemology. Types of knowledge. Plato has discussed four types of knowledge. They are number 1, conjectural knowledge. It is the lowest type of knowledge. It is not regarded as knowledge. Rather, it is only an appearance of knowledge. It includes illusions, hallucinations, dreams, errors, etc. For example, the illusion of silver in shell, snake in rope, the son of a barren woman, etc. This type of knowledge is hence always erroneous in nature. Note, a comparison can be drawn between Plato's conjectural knowledge and Pratibhasika knowledge of Advaita Vedanta school of Shankara. Pratibhasika knowledge is known as apparent knowledge or knowledge based on imagination. Some of the examples of ephemeral knowledge are those experiences in which the mind alone constructs its own reality, like one's dream and the perception of a rope as a snake. This is regarded to be the lowest grade of knowledge according to Shankara also. Number 2, practical knowledge. It means knowledge which is gained through sense organs. It deals with 5 sense organs and includes knowledge from visual, auditory, olfactory, gustatory and tactile organs. As a result, it deals with the knowledge of color, sound, smell, taste and skin sensations. So, it gives us the knowledge of the particulars. In other words, a knowledge of the things of the material world constitute to practical knowledge. Although this knowledge via sense organs seemed complete, but in reality it is incomplete in nature. Hence, it is incomplete knowledge. Note, a comparison can be drawn between Plato's practical knowledge and Vyavaharika knowledge of Advaita Vedanta school of Shankara. Vyavaharika knowledge, like practical knowledge of Plato, deals with existence and truth of the material world, which is pragmatic in nature. It is ever-changing and empirically true at a given period of time only. So, it is not completely true in nature. It is the knowledge of our phenomenal world, the world of experience, that we go through in our everyday life when we are awake. Hence, it is incomplete knowledge. Number 3 is hypothetical knowledge. According to Plato, this is not final but only hypothetical knowledge. It includes the knowledge of numbers and forms, and it is used in subjects such as mathematics, logic, etc. It is called hypothetical because we arrive at the truths or conclusions only via the process of logical deductions and inductive generalizations. And those truths or conclusions are primarily dependent on our sensory knowledge, which is dependent on our sense organs. According to Plato, hypothetical knowledge is the mediator between the practical and the fourth kind of knowledge, that is, the rational knowledge. Number 4. Rational knowledge. Rational knowledge is the highest form of knowledge. The rational knowledge gives us the knowledge of forms, concepts, ideas, etc. It is achieved via the dialectical process, as advocated by Socrates, unhindered by the sense organs or sensory experience. As a result, it gives us the knowledge of the universals and not particular. For example, the concept of cowness is only possible by the means of rational knowledge. The nature of knowledge. According to Plato, knowledge is not perception. Knowledge is attained through concepts. It is objective in nature, or it does not change with personal experiences of the individuals. It is permanent because it is not based on sense experience but reason. Hence, according to Plato, knowledge deals with concepts, reasons, or rational thinking. It always deals with the knowledge of the universals and never the particulars. Refer to the fourth type of knowledge, that is the rational knowledge, which according to Plato is the highest form of knowledge. Knowledge is also not based on opinions, neither right opinions nor wrong opinions. According to him, for example, if a person declares that there will be rain tomorrow, this statement cannot be regarded as knowledge because it is simply a work of blind guess. On the other hand, if it indeed rains the next day, then also it cannot be regarded as knowledge because it could simply be an instance of accident which came to be true. So, knowledge is not based on instincts or opinions or imagination. Knowledge is only based on reason. It deals with rational comprehension. Questions. Number 1. Phaedo, Republic, Theaetetus, etc. are A. Early dialogues, B. Middle dialogues, C. Late dialogues, D. None of these. The correct answer is middle dialogues. Question 2. Dash, according to Plato, is the lowest kind of knowledge. A. Hypothetical knowledge, B. Conjectural knowledge, C. Practical knowledge, D. All of these. The correct answer is conjectural knowledge. Conjectural knowledge, according to Plato, is the lowest type of knowledge. It is not regarded as knowledge. Rather, it is only an appearance of knowledge. Question 3. Practical knowledge is similar to Shankara's concept of A. Vyavaharika knowledge, B. Pratibhasika knowledge, C. Paramarthika knowledge, D. None of these. The correct answer is Vyavaharika knowledge. Question 4. Dash dialogue of Plato deals with negative epistemology. A. Theaetetus, B. Republic, C. Meno, D. Both A and B. The correct answer is Theaetetus. Theaetetus deals with negative epistemology and Republic deals with positive epistemology. Question 5. Select the correct code in relation with Plato's nature of knowledge. 1. Knowledge is not perception. 2. Knowledge is not based on intuition, beliefs, etc. 3. Knowledge deals with rational comprehension. 4. Knowledge is based on right opinions and not wrong opinions. 5. Knowledge deals with universals and not particulars. C. Knowledge is attained through concepts. Code A. All of them are true. B. 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6 are true. C. 1, 2, 4, 5 and 6 are true. D. 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6 are true. The correct answer is B. That is, the statements 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6 are true. Knowledge is not perception. Knowledge is not based on intuition. Knowledge deals with rational comprehension. Knowledge deals with universals and not particulars. Knowledge is attained through concepts and not percepts.